It's Tuesday. It's been 8 days since the election, or 7 days if you're talking like a gringo. In Mexico, the week is 8 days. When you say, I'll see you in 8 days, nos vemos en 8 días, you mean you'll see you 1 week. Anyhow, it's been a week since the election, and, well, I don't need to say anything about that. We're all taking it in our own way. Some of us are doing our little victory dances and giving the finger to the losers. And some of us are weeping and moaning and groaning because our candidate lost, even though she's really got problems and she definitely lost. She may have gotten more of the popular vote, but a fool more, for if she is, she lost. But that's not what I want to talk about. What I want to talk about is something very delightful which happened to me in my personal life today. You know, I've been renting ever since my darling last woman of my life, la última, the ultimate woman, Maria Teresa de Jesus Salazar Tovar. Ever since she moved back to Texas to be with her family, she was incredibly, incredibly sick. And after a year, she left us forever. But when she moved, I said, you know, I'll keep paying your rent just so you'll have the apartment when you come back. And it was an apartment that she and I had rented together on April 15th, 2004. 12 years and 9, 10 months, I don't know what it'll be. In April, it'll be 11 years. No, in April, it'll be 13 years. From 2004 to 2017. Will be 13 years since we rented that apartment. And I went to see our landlady today. She called and said, oh, I'll be over in Chula Vista, which is a big saving for me. I don't have to cross the border. It's a real hassle crossing the border. I don't like to do it. I just want to go there and stay there. I don't want to come back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. No. So she called and said she was in Chula Vista shopping and could I meet her today and pay her the rent? Because today is the 15th and the rent's due. Since we moved in on the 15th of April, 13 and a half years ago, the rent's always been due on the 15th. So I thought, well, hell. That's convenient. I don't have to worry about crossing over into Mexico. So, we drove down. My mom and I got in the car and I drove down to Chula Vista. Yeah, Chula Vista. That's where the lovely daddy lived with nearby his own beloved Irene. Hi, Irene. She still lives there. And he'll be back pretty soon, I bet. Anyhow, my mom and I drove down to Chula Vista Costco. And there she was. My dear, sweet old landlady. She's not too old. She's only a couple years older than I am. But she's lost her husband. And she's a widow. And living alone in the house that he built, and he bought the land and built the house for her. They had 3 kids there in the 70s and the 80s when that part of town was a whole new part of town. They called it New Tijuana. And now everybody calls it Modules, or in Spanish, Módulos. Yeah. And I've still rented the apartment there. My dearest Maria Teresa left there in 2014. It'll be 3 years ago this spring that she left. And I said, don't worry, I'll pay the rent. It's $350, which isn't that much. And I've always thought, well, I can go live there after my mom leaves. Well, it's starting to look like my mom's not going to leave for a long time. She didn't want to go on the trip last week before last, but she's a tough old gal. And I keep feeding her. It's going to be dinner time pretty soon. I got to get in the house. So I got to make this short, but I did want to say that we drove down and paid the rent, and our landlady, my landlady, paid me an enormous compliment. She said to me, if you do move out, Daniel, of course we were talking in Spanish, mind you, if you do move out and someone else moves in, whenever you want to come back, I'll just tell them to get out. She said she would throw out whoever she'd rented it. She would tell them they have to leave because Daniel is coming back. And I thought, oh, what a sweetheart. What a sweetheart. How could she say that? To get rid of a tenant just to have me back. So, well, all of a sudden I don't want to stop paying rent to her. She's cleaned the place up and fixed it with new bars because people broke in and stole stuff. There wasn't much there, just some plates and pictures on the wall. But she's been taking care of it. And I've been paying the rent month after month, $350. Which isn't bad for a three-bedroom apartment for $350. Come on, and you know, in Mexico, the electricity is like $20 a month. And the water is less. Of course, you have to buy your gas. You have to have your tanks of gas delivered by the trucks, but that's only $20 or $30 a month. And if you go to the markets and buy your food wisely, it costs about a half of what food costs in the United States. God, but that's not why I miss Mexico. I miss Mexico because of the language and my friends there, mis amigos mexicanos, los poetas y artistas que conozco en Tijuana. But as long as my mom is alive, I'm here with her. Yeah. I still have work, which is a good thing. I do translating work, as I know some of you have, I've told you before. But I miss Mexico. I miss it a lot. And someday, God willing, and the creek don't rise, I will move back to Mexico. Goodbye for now, my friends.